Hey there, Basic Dude again, bringing you our ninth mission in our basic training. As you see, we're going to do the standard, check our mission archives, take a quick glance at Star Map, view the available missions coming forward, and then we're going to take a trip over to the laboratory. In the lab, we're going to check out the console, and we're going to see how our research is, what research is available to us. And we see that we have two choices here. We've got vanadium plating, which increases the life, and we have ultra capacitors, which increase the hit power, and we're going to choose the ultra capacitors. Always good to have more hitting power. Remember always to check out those highlighted items in all of your screens. Right now we're going to go see what new mercenaries were added from our last mission, and you'll see it's the Spartan Company, which are beefed up Goliaths. There we go. And off to the armory we're going to go. In the armory, we're going to see if we want to spend some of our hard-earned money. And there's nothing available in the base. The Marauders need an upgrade, and we want to increase their life via the kinetic foam. We see that costs $90,000. We're going to go ahead and acquire that. And now we're going to go visit the bridge. And again, take a look at the two missions that are available to us. Again, we're doing these missions on a casual basis for training purposes. And so here we go. The first mission is the dig. And it's a great mission. It's going to give us a great piece of equipment. The siege tank, and actually, I like to have that piece of equipment for every mission, but you can't get the tank until you do the dig. And then here we've got the Great Train Robbery, which gives us the diamond back, an interesting piece of equipment, kind of a fun piece of equipment, and actually we're going to do this particular mission, the Great Train Robbery. If I had my options, I'd hold it off till we had the tanks available, especially for the hard, brutal levels. But right now, we're going to go ahead and do this mission first. I should make mention here that we've gone through an update of our video capture software from Debut. The update is a little rocky. We've lost a lot of quality. Debut said that their software was not great at 3D game recording. And the update is definitely not great at this. So for right now, we're going to tolerate it, move forward until we can figure out what we need to change or how to do this. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and get ready for the Great Train Robbery. Now, this mission, again, isn't casual. This isn't all prior casual missions. There's a kind of lax in defense. In this particular mission, you get a great edge against the Dominion. And that great edge is that all the buildings and all of the Dominion forces are at one half of the regular life. So, for example, the bunker, which is normally 400, has a 200 life. Individual units like the Marine, who has a normal 45 hit life, is got a life of 22, so you've got a great advantage here. against the Dominion forces. Let's go ahead and start our mission. First thing you always want to do is get your SCV started in terms of mining. And in this particular mission, you've got a number of objectives. First objective is to obtain the Diamondbacks, which are scattered throughout the map, and to obtain the Zerg research credits, you have to find three sets of Defiler bones. Diamondbacks that are readily available are the three highlighted items on your map. And if you see on the bottom section of the lit up portion of your map, you see a gold item that's your Defiler bone marked. Now, if you send your Marines over to the second, or we're calling the second, Diamondback, you'll pick up another set of Defiler bones, which sit just outside the hiding place of that Diamondback. And while if you've received those, you're going to pick up some of those mineral pallets and grab the Diamondback, which is also on that platform. And again, for my Marines, my Bio Army, I'm using Control 1. My Diamondbacks are Control 2. In the casual mission, we're going to pretty much split those between the two of them. And again, I should just say at this point that the strategy we're employing here is really limited to the casual and normal level. Once you get to hard, this thing gets a lot more difficult, a lot more fun. And we're going to make mention of most of the items that are differences between the levels. Here we're going for a unmarked Diamondback, which is right there. And if you're looking at your mini map, you can see its placement. You'll pick up a mineral pallet, and you're going to get four Diamondbacks available for your first mission, first train rather, and you'll get some more minerals. Now, just so we make it clear, these Diamondbacks are the heart of the mission, and when you get into the hard and brutal levels, they are like gold to you. And speaking of gold, you're going to need to watch your minerals. Not so much at the casual and hard level, because you've got more than adequate minerals in your base, and more than adequate Vespene gas. But when it comes to the hard and brutal level, in a couple minutes we'll mention the differences in terms of minerals available. But here comes our first train. First train is not guarded at all. It's kind of slow moving, and it's easy pickings. So go ahead and attack the train with all your forces. Your Diamondbacks should always be focused on the train. And we're going to go ahead and take this bad boy out. Notice that the train only has a hit point life of 2,000. At the casual level, that's consistent. At the normal level, at the hard level, the life of the train goes up to 3,000, a 50% increase. Quite significant. Very significant. When we get to brutal, that train's life becomes 3,500. So, very important. Big difference. You're gonna experience this when you get to those levels. Again, keep in mind we're showing you a strategy which is more than adequate for the normal and casual, And again, we'll be pointing out the variations you need to succeed at the hard and brutal levels. So again, first strategy is know that you're going to have less time between trains, and the trains will increase in hit point values as the levels get harder. We're going to go out right now and gather up some more of the Diamondbacks and the set of Defiler Bones. And there's another Diamondback, and some minerals which we're going to pick up. Now, in hard and brutal levels, other than the first four Diamondbacks which we acquired, again, all other Diamondbacks are guarded with Dominion forces. And they are pretty rugged, especially at the brutal level. It's not a cakewalk after this one. After
looks like we found all the
casual level, which actually normal is even though there's not as much defense, the significant increase in the unit's lives alone, just because it requires more time to destroy them because of their increased life. It makes the mission a lot more difficult, even at the casual level. Casual, normal level. But let's keep on going forward. We're going to go ahead and find that last set of Defiler Bones. And again, this is kind of by memory. But if you're drawing a straight line from where the two highlighted Diamondbacks were, if you go almost a straight line south, you'll come across that last set of Defiler Bones. Also, you can pick them up, which is probably the way you'll pick them up in the hard and brutal levels, and I believe it's the fifth train. Now, here comes our second train, and again, it's got some an escort with it, but again, because it's at half life, that escort is not very strong, and we're going to go ahead and attack it. Should make mention here that first procedure, no matter what we're viewing here, because of the diminished lives, which look very simple, first procedure in all of your attacks is to eliminate that escort. Don't attack the train specifically, attack an area, if you will, to eliminate the escort. If you don't eliminate the escort, they will decimate your attacking forces. And that's not only at the normal level, but definitely at the hard and brutal level. You will cry if you don't get rid of that escort. Also, always after you've completed a mission, especially in the hard and brutal level, come back to your base. You will be attacked. After that second train, we're going to receive an attack at the southern base entrance. That's forthcoming in the second year.
Sounds like they're planning to attack our base.
Casual level, not that significant. When it comes to the other levels, please be prepared. Have your people there. We're going to note these items to you, pound it into you, because when you get to hard and brutal, especially, if you're not there, you're not going to win. And either way, they're going to decimate your forces, so get back in there and get ready to defend your base. Again, a minor attack at the casual level, more severe at the other levels. Third train, you need to get ready for. So, again, we're going to go ahead and search our way out. And where is it we were going? We're going to the northwest side, even though that third train comes to the bottom. But so we're going to have to swing around and meet that train so we can dispatch it and keep our motion in terms of gaining all the achievements. By the way, the achievements on this particular mission are: one, to complete the primary objectives, another is to kill the Marauder hit team, which will be coming up shortly, and the other is to not miss a train in the mission. We will accomplish that in the casual level. All of these are doable at all of the levels, but boy is it hard to do at the brutal level. Here we go, we're meeting that third train, and notice if you can get in that center area, you've got more face time, if you will, with the entire train. All your troops can attack it, you know, as it's doing that arc. So if you can be in a position to attack it there, please do so. Another thing I'm going to point out to you in a second here. Do you recall where that second little isthmus or peninsula, if you will, on our base, just to the left of where you see our Diamondbacks there? You go out there with your Diamondbacks after the next mission, after the next train rather, and plant your Diamondbacks there en masse. That is a good snipe point. And I say snipe point for the Marauder team in the hard and brutal level. As they walk by, you'll be able to pick off some of those guys and make your life a lot easier. So keep that in mind. I think if you watch the Great Train Robbery hard level video that I've got coming up, you'll see what I mean more definitely, but I'll make mention of it here. So, at this point, what the Dominion's done is placed out some bunkers for defense along the train route. Again, you want to take the time, if you can, to clear them out. Casual level makes this quite simple. Normal, it's a reasonable chore. Hard and brutal, very difficult, but very important. Do what you can. The time between trains on this casual and normal level is 3 minutes. That drops to 2 minutes and 30 seconds after the hard level. So you want the time between trains becomes 2.5 minutes after the hard and brutal levels. So this is very significant. But you want to do as much as you can, because attacking the trains and then running into one of these bunker areas, again, will severely damage your forces, could stop you from attacking or destroying that train, and in any case, it's going to put a big hurt on your forces. So again, take that trip around your center base area to eliminate the bunkers as best you can during the time you have available. Don't risk your forces to miss a train in any case, and I'll explain that in a second also. Here we come upon the next train. Now, as you see each train, the escorts become a little bit more substantial, and this is definitely true throughout the missions. But again, we're in that center area, we've got significant face time with the train, and we dispatch it quite quickly at this particular level. In the meantime, we're building our forces. Now, the train drops off these mineral pellets after it's destroyed. I should make mention here that you'll have abundant minerals available to you in the casual and normal level. Actually, your main base has 18,177 mineral units in the hard and normal levels. That is going to go down to 4,765 mineral units at the hard and brutal level. Very significant. Almost a quarter. And up in the upper right-hand corner, just between the area where we receive, there we go, we're coming into it now, where you're going to have an expansion. Now, in the hard level, you may be able to utilize the expansion. I don't know necessarily that you'll have the time available to do it in brutal, but that expansion is available. And in that expansion, there's 6,081 additional minerals, but in the hard and brutal level, that'll decrease to 3,298. Now, just to give you the sum total, what that means is you're going to be down to almost one-third of the total minerals available to you in the hard and brutal level. And if you take any losses in the hard and brutal level, it's going to be significant. So again, keep this in mind. Now, to offset some of the decrease in the mining minerals available to you, trains will spill off more mineral pallets, but they're not going to be able to make up that big discrepancy. So it's one of the reasons why when it gets into the brutal level, you're only allowed to miss two trains. And up until that point, as long as you don't miss three trains, the mission will continue. I will say that if you miss one train in the brutal level, you'll keep your missions in jeopardy anyway from lack of minerals. Two trains, you'll never make it anyway. Here comes our next train. And again, if the escorts are getting more substantial, but we are going to be able to dispatch it at the casual level. You will be able to dispatch it at the other levels, but greater care will be required. And so we're going to keep on going here. Again, we're building our forces at this point because of the life and hit point value of the Dominion forces. We're going to go ahead and actually attack and destroy all of the launching areas for the trains. That's not going to stop the trains from coming. It's just something to pass the time, if you will, and give you a little bit of clear map. Now, you can do this at the casual level, and you're going to watch it here with me. You can do it at the normal level. I don't know if you can do it at the hard and brutal. I can't. In fact, I don't even have the time to try it. So you might as well enjoy your fun here. In terms of destroying the Dominion, they will get even with you. So anyway, we've gone ahead and sent in our bio ball into the base. Well, in the normal level, you will want to use a combined army with your Diamondbacks, only because of the increase in life. This diminished life of the buildings and the defenders makes it not too laborious for the bio ball to take care of it quite efficiently. Even then, as you see, we have a number of units there, so it's not that impossible to do. So keep it going. Now we're gonna, right now, if you see where the bio ball is placed, and I guess I'm, you know, fortunate in terms of the placement, at least at this time. That's actually where the Marauder group is spawning from, and I've delayed their spawn by a couple of seconds, and it actually shows up in the game time, which I didn't realize until I did this playback. But as I move away from that particular area, because the next train is coming, is almost simultaneously with the announcement of the train, give us the message that the Marauder team is also out there. We'll talk about the significance of the Marauder team in a second, as we're going to move our attacking forces into position to meet the next train. And you'll notice in a second here,
sir,
there's Matt giving us the advice that there's a Marauder team, and that Marauder team will show up right there. That's a little skull outfit that's going to be walking around.
Still, you should try to avoid.
Here we're going to go ahead and attack this train. And in the meantime, that Marauder unit's coming up behind us. And we're going to go ahead and engage that now. This particular unit only has 8 Marauders in it at the casual level. And we dispatched those pretty easily. Didn't even interrupt our train attack. In the normal level, that group will increase to 12. Not necessarily significant, but it is an increase. When we get to hard, there's 16 Marauders in that unit, and again, very significant because they're upgraded, and you need to watch that. So take advantage of that little peninsula that I showed you before. Here we're attacking into the base between the two train stations. Very significant. Be careful here. You're going to come across what is significant even at the casual level. A couple of sieged up tanks, the planetary fortress, a couple of tanks. We're going to take some losses here at the casual level. If you do this with a bio-only army in your normal level, I'm going to think you're going to get chewed up pretty good, may not even succeed. So again, do that with combined forces. It is doable. Going back to our Marauders. At the brutal level, again, at hard level, you've got 16 Marauders, very significant, very powerful. You want to snipe them from that peninsula if you can. At the brutal level, you've got 2 teams of Marauders with 12 each in them, 12 Marauders, and they're supplemented with, I believe it's 4 nurses, which we all know the nurses help extend the lives with their healing power. So you've got 2 Marauder teams, very significant. We'll put a crimp in your style no matter what you do. Be careful when you deal with them. They will put the hurt on you. Whether they're, again, the Marauders, destroying the Marauders is the hard achievement, I believe, on the, no, it's the normal achievement on the, at the normal level. You can do that. It's not a required achievement. After that, you may want to completely avoid them in the brutal level. So just keep that in mind. You may want to avoid them at the brutal level, even though they are, their attack path is coordinated with the train paths. So whether you can actually really avoid them may be a stretch. So keep that in mind. When you meet them, you're going to not greet them. You're going to be sad. So anyway, we're going to continue in clearing the train bases here. We're going to clear that one base while we let the Diamondbacks attack the outcoming train. Now, this train is not guarded. It's got a speed-up value, as we were advised by Swan, and since it's got no, real escort with it, we didn't include our bio army. And actually, at the hard and brutal level, the escort is made up of Hellions, and it's not that significant. You should be able to dispatch them quite readily, but again, always dispatch escorts before you attack the train. Do not focus on the train and let the escorts damage your units. You will pay the consequences on that. So again, continuing on the destruction of the left base, or the launching bases. We're almost done. We've got the last area to get into, and it's going to be quite timely because we're going to have the final train coming out. Here we go. We're going to clear that this last base area. Because we cleared the Dominion base areas, you will, without clearing those, the Dominion will continue to attack your base after each train. Prior to the Marauders arriving, had we not destroyed that base up in the north section, we would have received a attack at our base in the north, entrance. Again, not necessarily significant, but it is damaging. After this last train that we just dispatched, there would have been an attack in the southern base, southern entrance of our base. And again, somewhat challenging, I guess is the better word to use. Not necessarily totally destructive. You want to have your forces there again on the hard and brutal level. After you've dispatched the train, bring your forces back in to make that defense, defensive stance against the Dominion's attack. Just the words of the wise. We want to go ahead and continue clearing out that last, this last bunker emplacement here that we're going to deal with on the on this level. Now, again, we cleared out that west portion of the map. Right portion of the map is, I just really don't know if we got enough time to clear it all, and I did start a little bit late on the clearing portion. It's doable if you, kind of rush for our training purposes. Obviously, I do want to get this some of these pointers out to you, not necessarily clear the map for you, but it does make the mission a little bit more fun if you, at the casual level, if you include that in your objectives. There's not a lot there. A small base in that little triangular area in the south. Other than that, it's not that significant, but it does make the casual level a little bit more interesting. Here we go. This is what will be the final train, even though the game mission clock is saying there's another train. There is not another train. Once you get this one, it's done. It's over. Woohoo. You win if you get the train. Now, at the brutal and hard level, you see these are, this is more significant of an escort. At those levels, at the upper levels, it is a very significant escort. It actually becomes, if you will, an all-in for yourself and your forces at the brutal level. At least it was for me, and I made it an all-in at the hard level, as you'll see in the video, just for snicks. But gets to be significant. So there you see what the prize is from all this mission, and it's that adjutant. And we're going to include a little bit of her story after our scoreboard, just so I can take a couple extra seconds to reiterate what we're what we're talking about in terms of the future missions. There's our scoreboard. You're going to see that we've accomplished all the mission achievements. Took some light damage in terms of our units. But again, I think clearing the board makes it a lot more fun. So here's that last cinematic. And again, don't attack the Marauder groups at the hard and brutal level. If you can avoid them, snipe them in the hard level and that little isthmus if you can. Come back to your base for defense. Watch your minerals, especially after the normal level. You won't have many. Get all the trains you can. You'll need those minerals. And right now, I'm going to say that's just about it. Basic dude saying, take care, bye-bye, hope you had fun, and hope to see you again soon. Take care.